Hi everyone. So in the previous video, we saw how to derive values of trigonometric ratios for 45 degrees. Now in this video, we will see the derivation of trigonometric ratios for two angles, which are 30 degrees and 60 degrees. So for this video, 30 degree and 60 degree. Okay. Now in the previous video, what we did was we have to find an angle or the ratios of 45 degrees. So we made an 45, 45, 90 triangle. So let us see what we can do. So this is 90 and we need to draw 30 and 60. So which angle will be 30 degrees? This one, right? The smaller angle will subtend a smaller side. And similarly, a larger angle will subtend a larger side. Now what can we do? If you think about it, we really can't do anything, right? We don't know the side ratio of the sides. We don't know the sides, so we really can't use this a lot of drawing triangles every time. Now there is another figure, a really interesting figure, which has 60 degrees as a prominent angle in it. Now which figure am I talking about? Those who have watched the prerequisite video, you know what I'm talking about, right? I'm talking about, yes, an equilateral triangle. So let us draw an equilateral triangle. Okay. There you go. Equilateral enough. And what's the special property of an equilateral triangle? That it has all the three sides equal and all the angles equal. Okay. This will be 60 degree and this will be 60 degree. Now, okay, we have drawn a triangle. Now how can we make a right angle triangle in it? See, what if we just draw a perpendicular to the base? Yeah, we get a right angle triangle just like we want. And what properties we know about this very special line in an equilateral triangle? Line which is perpendicular to the base drawn from a vertex. This line divides the base into two equal parts. And it divides this angle into two equal parts. Correct. So if this side length is x, then this side length will also be x, right? Because all the three sides are equal. So this length will also be x. And what about these two? If these two are equal and these two joined to form a length of x, so this must be x by 2. This must be x by 2, right? Basics. Now, what do we notice? The angles, right? If this is 60 degree, and then this line divides it into, the median divides it into two equal parts, so this will be 30 degrees, right? And this will be 30 degrees. Now, if you look closely in this triangle, okay, we get what we want, right? So, let me just, you can rub it, okay? Now we have what we want, right? So we have a right angle triangle and we have all the ratios required. So this is x, this is x by 2, this is 60 degree, and this will be 30 degree. This will be 90, of course. So we have got two sides of a right angle triangle and we want to find the third side. Easy, right? You can use the Pythagoras theorem. So I'm not going to do the entire derivation, I'm just straight away going to write the thing. Okay, this side length will be 3x by root 3x by 2. You can do this yourself, right? Straightforward application of Pythagoras theorem. So now we have everything we need, right? We need the angle, we have 60 degree, we have 30 degree. We have the sides, we have x by 2, root 3x by 2 and x. So now it's a piece of cake, right? Let me just draw. And now we can find all the ratios. So what I am going to do in this video, we will solve for three ratios, sine, cos and tan, because the rest of them are the reciprocals of it. So no need to derive all of them. So for, let us take 60 degree, okay? For 60 degree, what will be the sine of 60 degree? Now you should be able to do this, so you should pause the video and try to do this on your own, okay? So now that you have paused the video and gave it a try, let us look at it. Sine 60 degree will be ratio of perpendicular to the हाइपोटेन्यूज, सो रूट थ्री एक्स बाई टू अपॉन एक्स, ओके सो अपॉन इंटू वन बाई एक्स, वी कैन ऑल्सो राइट दिस कैंसल्स आउट एंड वी गेट रूट थ्री बाई टू. इज इन सो लेट मी जस्ट राइट अराउंड द रिजल्ट. साइन 60 डिग्री इज इक्वल टू रूट थ्री बाई टू. ओके नाउ वट अबाउट कॉस 60 डिग्री. अगेन कॉस 60 डिग्री विल बी बेस अपॉन हाइपोटेन्यूज, सो x by 2 upon x, you can write 1 upon x as 1 by x, okay, so this cancels out and we get 1 by 2. So you can write cos 60 degree be equal to 1 by 2. And then what about tan 60 degree? Tan 60 degree will be, you can have two ways to do this, right? You can have sin 60 degree divided by cos 60 degree, you get root 3. So let's just do it using sides. So root 3x by 2 upon x by 2, this you can write up 1 by x by 2 as 2 by x, right? So these things cancels out and you get root 3 as an answer. So tan, okay, 60 degree is root 3. Now for 30 degrees. Now again, 30 degrees is pretty easy. Again, if we look from 30 degrees point of view, this side will be the perpendicular, this side will be the base, and of course hypotenuse will remain the same. So again, what will be sine of 30 degrees? Sine of 30 degrees will be perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So x by 2, this will be the perpendicular for this case, upon 1 by x and 1 by 2. So sine 30 degree will be equal to 1 by 2. What about cos 30 degree? Again, cos 30 degree will be base, this is the base, upon hypotenuse. So root 3x by 2 upon x, so into 1 by x. They are the, basically the same, right? It is root 3 by 2. The x and x cancels out. Cancel out. Okay. So cos 30 degree will be root 3 by 2. And what about tan 30 degree? So again, yeah, you can use sine 30 degree upon cos 30 degree. We are just doing using the base, perpendicular upon base. So x by 2 upon root 3x by 2. So into 2 upon root 3x. Okay, x cancels out, the 2 cancel out, and we get 1 by root 3 as our answer. So tan 30 degree will be 1 by root 3. So now that we are done, you know, calculating the values of trigonometric ratios for 60 degree and 30 degree, and we are left with three ratios, right? So you can do this yourself, that cosec 60 degree will be the reciprocal of sine 60 degree, so it will be root 3 by 2. So now you can choose, pick any of them you like, and you can solve for the reciprocals as well. In this video, we have done it for 60 degree and 30 degree. Two more angles are remaining. And these two are pretty interesting angles, because if we try and draw these diagrams, we find very interesting things that how, you know, you can lessen the side gradually as you lessen, as you reduce this angle, how this side will reduce. So we will meet in the next video. Till the time, you can complete this table of your own.